sacrifice. Your word says, live and not die. Oh Lord, speak into my life.
You don't know what you have until you lose it. You don't know what you're enjoying until you take steps that move you out of your place of planting. You don't know. You don't know. It's when you have moved out, you say, Kai. But if you can be humble enough, God will bring you back and restore you. The problem is that you don't know what you have. Adam did not know what he had until he lost it. He was used to everything free in the garden. Eating of every tree. Control. He didn't know what he had until he stepped out of Eden after the fall. You don't know what you have. And let me tell you, detour is one step away. One step out of the place of your planting equals to detour. And detour from the place of your planting can sentence you to a dry land. The Bible says in Psalm 68 verse 6, it says, God sets the solitary into families. In other words, the solitary means single soul, solitary, into family. Family is a symbol of increase, multiplication. But he said that the rebellious dwell in a dry land. There's something about the land where you dwell. If you are rebellious, you find that a land that was fruitful for others can become dry for you. And one of the things that, you know, bets rebellion is an attitude of pride, an attitude of unteachability. Never get to the point where you can give heed to advice, where you become somebody who is unteachable. That is a nature that can put you out of the will of God. And once you step out of God's will, before you know it, you begin to wander like it were in the wilderness. May not be your testimony. A lot of people are experiencing dry land situations because they are facing the tears in the place of their planting. Once you shift, you will know what you've been missing. You know, many think that they know what they are doing. All the ways of a man are clean in his eyes. Proverbs 16 verse 2. All the ways, Bible says all the ways, you can justify your actions and still be out of the will of God. You can justify why you do the things you do. They are clean in your eyes. They are pure. They appear like very pure motifs before you. But the Bible said that God weighs the spirit. I know that God, that means God weighs motives. But the spirit also means God weighs the unsightable. Men act because of the sightable, but God weighs the unsightable. And many times we don't know that that unsightable is what is the clincher to the place of the fulfillment of our purpose. Many times we think that is what is seen that is an enabler to our achieving our goals. You can all you get today and may not be alive to enjoy it. That's what the leaders of Nigeria don't understand. You can fight, do all you need to do. Then when the right time comes, you drop dead. Because you may think you can control everything because you have money. But when it comes to life, you can't control life. There's a limit to how you can control life. I am telling you, you had leprosy and leprosy couldn't go. Leprosy was a reproach that brought disgrace. Leprosy brought ostracization. Leprosy brought rejection. Yet he had the bag of money. Do you realize that he never even returned the bag of money? He still carried it about, but he carried it with leprosy. May you not carry that which does not belong to you and still carry leprosy. Because leprosy is what can keep you grounded, keep you a reject, keep people hissing at you. No matter how fulfilled you may appear, leprosy puts you in a position of disgrace, a position of shame. As time goes on, the bells you tie on your foot because you are leprous will be ringing even before people who don't know you. And anywhere you pass, people will say, they will hiss. May it not be your testimony. May you not fight to get something that God has not ordained for you. And yet you carry fire that will burn your bosom. I say, may it not be your portion. May your blessing not be self-destructive. Amen. Oh my God. Why sleep around? Get all the promotion. But at the end of the day, your womb is locked. Why sleep around, get all the promotion in the office? At the end of the day, you find out that everything about you is headed towards the wrong direction. The devil never gives you anything without taking anything from you. Are you following what I'm saying? The devil never gives you anything without requiring something. He told Jesus Christ, you know, took him to the mountain and said, I will give you all the kingdoms of the earth in a moment of time. Jesus Christ looked at it. It was so juicy. Someone say it was so juicy. It was inviting. It looked good. Ah, you know, people will hail me. People can hail you, yet you're heading for hell. After the hailing, what is your predestination? Where are you, where is your destination? They can hail you, but you're hellbound. May not be your portion. You know, some of our leaders who fight tooth and nail, trying to be in the place of authority by all means, do human sacrifices. You can employ 1,000 marabouts. You can do all you want to do, absolutely. I think you can get away with it. But the payday is close. Let me tell you, the payday is close. Closer than you think. The payday is close. And God knows what he's doing. He was gathering them. Gathering them bit by bit. So that at the end of the day, he will not escape it. He's gathering them bit by bit. But I'm telling you, the payday is sooner than you know it. Because some people think they can just do anything and get away with it. I can do anything I want to do. I can shut people's mouth. I can act the way I want. I can act arbitrarily and nothing will happen. Let me tell you something. Even when you just decide, oh, God keeps quiet, it doesn't mean that God is weak. Bible said that God is not slack concerning his promise as men think slackness to be. Sometimes God is long-suffering waiting for people to repent. When they fail to repent, God will be justified. You know what I'm saying? Let's turn to Isaiah 59. Let me show you something. Isaiah 59 from verse 15. We'll read. Yeah. Truth faileth. He that departs from evil. In Nigeria now, when you depart from evil, you are an idiot. According to them. When you fail to do the right thing, you are a fool. That's the scenario playing out. He that departs from evil makes himself a prey. And people come out openly and say, you can never win this thing. Because you don't play the game we play. You don't belong to the same court we belong to. You don't do the level of sacrifice we do. Forgetting that the Most High rules in the kingdom of men and gives it to whomsoever he wills. Let me tell you, no matter what happens, the scriptures cannot be broken. People are beginning to say, all these pastors, shut your mouth! Stop saying nonsense. It's not a matter of all these pastors. Somebody was saying, all these politicians go to the pastors, they prophesy to them, and they think that's what wins election. So election is that you must dine with somebody you're not supposed to dine with. You must form alliances with the devil. You must form covenants with the adversary. So God cannot give you kingship. That's what they're trying to say. As long as Nigeria is concerned, it's a different case. Bible does not work here. That's what they're saying. This Bible, it doesn't work here. Because what we feel that we prayed. How else will God answer this prayer? Father, we have prayed. At the time, I even told you I'm not praying again. I should also tell you that power is taken, not just given. Power is taken. If you think you realize that, they'll come and give you power. Remember? Power is taken, not just given. That's why if you deliberately want power in the things of God, you must take it. You can't relax and say, power will come. You will take it. All the things, steps you need to take, take it. That's how you grow in the things of the Spirit. He that departs from evil makes himself a prey. The Lord saw it. A lot of people don't see it. I just watch the nonsense. In fact, I just say, oh, watch the nonsense that goes on TV. When right-thinking human beings, because of money. And you see, the problem is that people want to put themselves in a position where, you know, they will weaponize poverty. Impoverish the people so that nobody will have the temerity, the strength to fight. Because when you don't have money, how can you fight? There are other people are thinking about, how can we get Naira? That's the idea. I was wondering, this policy now, how did it affect? You see how the devil works? If you're not discerning, you will not understand. Yes, because this policy now, how did it help? Was it meant to stifle the people so that they will not be able to do what they're supposed to do while empowering the other people? While going ahead and saying, release money to them? We must talk. There's nothing, what are we afraid of? That is a height of wickedness. In fact, the level of wickedness I've seen, and I see men that are fathers, grandfathers, behaving like, oh my, I was sad. I felt bad. Because I can never imagine my father doing that. My father would never do it. So I didn't grow up seeing those kind of images as fathers. Then I'm seeing somebody now in the full glare of camera lying. So what are we trying to tell to the generation? I saw a good Nigeria when I was growing up. From the 70s. Are you following what I say? Many of you are not opportunity. That's why we are even praying and fighting that you will see a little bit of what you've seen. If you want to travel abroad, do you know how much flight ticket is? He that departs from evil makes himself a prey. The Lord saw it. He displeased. Please, people are saying that there's no justice system. You see, when it comes to God, God can move beyond the bad justice system. Is it not God? The heart of kings are in his hands. Because our situation here appears as if it is irredeemable. Everybody are already giving up. Somebody was saying, I'm not 4 years now. People have, no, it won't happen. Yes. That's why I told you that time God showed me a revelation. Didn't I tell you? Yes. Maybe others are pointing towards that a direction. Just like somebody, to subvert a man in his cause, the Lord does not approve. It's just like something is your own. Somebody says you will never have it. A fellow human being. And people are clapping for them. I said the spell that many people are under is too much. Thank God that you are in Christ. Lift up your hands and thank God. And you hear the things you hear. Because a lot of people are under serious spells. Because they are not behaving normally. You don't know that spells can be cast over nations. If I tell you the extent these people go to hijack the soul of a nation, you won't keep quiet. If I tell you the extent this will go to hijack the soul of cities, it didn't happen here, it's ordinary. Before what you say is impossible, before your very eyes, they are happening. But the movie just started. Watch and see. I was asking God another question. I said, God, why do we have to pray every time? And if instead of things to just follow the normal course, we have to be looking for a way to explain. Amen. It has to be corner. Why wouldn't it just happen naturally? So that there will be like Happy New Year. But there's Happy New Year too. Just that God will show his God. The Bible said that God will gather like sheaves into the threshing floor. Sometimes when they're gathering sheaves, it's bit by bit. Gathering sheaves. So many, they look upon Zion and say, let Zion be defiled. Let our eye look upon Zion. But they don't know the thoughts of the Lord. Neither do they understand his counsel. For the Lord shall do what? Gather them like sheaves into. Gathering sometime takes time. They are gathering. Because at that time, nobody will be able to escape. It's coming. I'm telling you, it is coming. What will happen before your eyes? You will say, wow. Was this God was planning? And we'll have roles to play. On Saturday, go out and vote. Because, you know, the idea is now, the plan of the devil is, now, which one will I do now? And people are really throwing away their people. I told somebody, that means you cannot even be a pastor. Any small thing, you have already given up. What is this one they are giving up? I don't even know. So, you've now resigned to FATE. No way. If you neglect the grassroots, these people have won. If you neglect the grassroots, that's from the governorship, they have taking over the place, and they will have enough war chest to fight you. So please, Saturday, go out and do what? Vote. In good conscience, not with sentiments. I'm telling you, praise the Lord. This is not about tribe. Amen? It's not. God knows. I went to a unity school. I don't think there's a mistake. Most of my friends are from other tribes. This is not about tribe. The problem we have in this country is that there are people who have hijacked the soul of this nation. And they want to keep eating. And somebody was saying the other day, they say, when we're in social studies, they'll tell us the youths are the future of tomorrow. Which future? It's our grandfathers that are the future of tomorrow. before your grandpa. In fact, many of you are even heading to grandpa now. By 10 years' time, you'll be grandfathers. That's the truth. And if care is not taken, at that level, you won't even touch the solo. You won't even touch anything. Because people keep perpetuating, after me, my son. That thing must stop. It's bad. My parents were not born again, but they could never. If you don't do well, they will not come and plead on your behalf. My father will not do it. God said, no. Still, you better than, I will not. I will not. And the truth is that what we are seeing today in Nigeria before our very eyes is that you mean nothing to these people. You will mean nothing to them. Amen. These people have left governors. I saw a governor talk, you know, a governor of Kogi State. What a young man. I'm telling you, these people are contemporaries. Amen. You know that we are doing the work of God. You come out and say, they can't afford this Naira policy. They can't afford the people to be suffering. I say, which people? Because it's affecting you now, and you want to put the people, that's why you are fighting the system. Let's watch it. The drama is playing out. This man has not even left. You see, they're overturning all these policies. And for them to tell you, you see, they want to resurrect an eyebrow. For them to tell you that this thing is going to affect, or rather, the governor mentioned that, don't worry, after election, we'll revert to the old Naira. We don't worry, everything. It means that everything has been predetermined. Do you see why there was no election? Everything had been arranged. When you see some results, you know why the devil is that? The devil will inspire you, but he will not make you perfect in that thing you are doing. You open hole. By the time we looked, some states had the same results. Copy and paste. This thing will be exposed, though. People are praying. Please don't stop praying. This thing will be exposed. It's not God we are serving. There's nothing hidden under the sun. There's nothing even hidden that will not come abroad. God will say the people are suffering from another policy. No. The money that they buried, they've not returned them to the banks. So by December 31st, all the 1,000 Naira notes that are somewhere, they'll bring them out now and put that in the system. The Lord saw it, displeased him, that there was no judgment. Somebody say no judgment. You would have thought that would have been the end of the story. Sometimes, even when there is nothing to lean on, even when there is no hope, or it appears that everything is hopeless, and your trust is still in God, it's not over yet. You know, God told me something. He said that, except there is death. You know, death, you bury everything. It's as if it's forgotten. There won't be resurrection. I believe that this Easter season, as we celebrate the resurrection, something will resurrect. Now look at verse 16. It says in verse 16, and he saw that there was no man. It's as if I don't even have any person. I wonder there was no what? We use this for prayer. But intercessor means a go-between. Which is good. Go to Amplify. Let me show them something here. And he saw that there was no man. I wonder there was no intercessor. No one to intervene. See it? No one to do what? Intervene on behalf of truth and right. Therefore, his own arm did what? Brought him victory, and his own righteousness, having the spirit of measure, sustained him. Contemporary English version say that, you know, his own righteousness, you know, brought forth the victory of truth. And I believe that the victory of truth will come to fore. Please, on Saturday, if you have your PVC, go out and vote. You see, all of us will determine the change in this nation. Don't leave it to, you've already known that this will not want me well. We will determine. That's why God is telling you, I'll play my part, tell you who to do, but God is going to use us to enforce his will. One of the ways is to go out. You know, probably they think the presidential election is what will spark off whatever, but this governorship election may also be what may spark off whatever. Praise the Lord. Because by the time you trouble people too much, do the first one, they keep quiet. You come and do this one, go out and vote. Praise the name of the Lord. Do you agree with me? Go out and do what? Tell your neighbor, say, go out and vote. Now, in the short moments, let me share what the Lord laid in my heart. You need faith and not a tape for God. You need what? Faith and not a tape. Tape is used to measure. You need faith and not a tape for God. Just because of the events playing out today that this message came to me. We've cried to God severally. For the Nigerian case, I remember from Lara Wolokun we prayed. Even before 2015. I remember, was it the night before the election or sometime within that election period, we had a listening in the church and prayed. We had prayed earnestly to God. I said, God, that's 8 years before. The same motions. Prayed again. I said, God, what's going on? Is it that our situation is so peculiar that prayer can no longer solve it? Or the amount of decadence in the realm of the spirit committed by these people is so strong that it needs a lot. But Lord, the blood can cleanse anything. The blood can cleanse anything. The blood can speak against anything. At least for the righteous people. If Abraham did not stand on the new covenant and will stand on the new covenant, I can give Abraham reprieve because of prayers. Lord, how much more we who are standing on the better covenant? You can give us reprieve over this nation. 230 million people. I saw a clip of what one Austrian paper wrote. You know, I would ask him as if I was an American and I heard the things happen here. It doesn't sound nice. If I was British and I saw the things or read the things happening in Nigeria, it looks like a banana republic kind of thing, isn't it? We don't believe that things like this can happen in the 21st century. But yet, it is how far we have gone. So God, we have prayed, we have done all kinds of things. Where many Nigerians have spoken. We've formed chains. People have done what they need to do. Lord, why is it appear? Why does it appear as if our harvest is not coming? Somebody say question. After all, he said that the expectation of the righteous, Proverbs 23 verse 18, the expectation of the righteous shall not what? Be cut off. That's what he said. How come it appears as if nothing is happening? What's going on? Have you ever come to that stage in your life where you've asked God, what's going on? I've come there several in my life. Many of you have not come there. Continue. Amen? Maybe you have to pray for me and give me that anointing that has made you not to ask God questions. But I have several times. Because God is a God of integrity. Praise the Lord. He watches over his word to perform it. And there's nothing wrong with asking God, why is this not happening? And God spoke to me, said to me, I said that the expectation of the righteous will not be what? I didn't say that the route to the manifestation will not be cut off. In other words, expectation may be straightforward, but I didn't tell you that the route will be straightforward. You know what I mean by route? The pathway does not always seem like the right way. That's why Proverbs 16 verse 2 says, all the ways of a man are clean in his eyes. And to be frank with you, we feel that we know the outcome of how things ought to be, or how God is going to do what he said he would do. And the truth about life is that a lot of people hail the process. They don't hail the end. Or a lot of people who hail the process don't mind what the end is going to turn out to be. What they want is what is happening at that moment determines the source of their joy or the strength of their praise. But many times God does not look at the process. Like, for instance, God would have said, the expectation of the righteous will not be what? Cut off. The process will also not be cut off. But God didn't mention, God doesn't really mention much about the process. All the ways of a man are what? But God wait, if you look at it, that means God wait motifs. But it can also be seen that all the ways of a man are clean in the sight. But God weighs what is unsightable. Because spirits are not sightable. Are you following what I'm saying? So God is dealing with the weight of what God deals with is unsightable. But the weight of what man deals with is what? Sightable. So all the ways of a man thinks he knows what he's doing. For all of us here, we think we know the outcome of how things ought to be in our lives. We feel that tomorrow should be like this. This is how God should order, don't do these things. But failing to understand that God orders the steps of a good man. God even hardened the heart of Pharaoh at some point. Do you know that? God hardened the heart of Pharaoh. Why would we have to go through Pharaoh? Because a man will say, why do I need Pharaoh? Lord, this is straightforward to you. You are a God that determines the end from the what? Do you know God determines the end from the beginning? He doesn't mention anything about the process. I determine the what? End from the what? He didn't mention what happens between the beginning and the what? Praise God. If you look at Proverbs 10:24, the Bible said that the Lord will grant the desires of the righteous. What happens before the place of inquest and the place of desire, God will not mention. But the Bible said God will grant the desires of the what? The desire of the righteous will do what? Granted. So it is a sure banker. But the problem is that how are you going to do it? And because man judges by sight, man thinks, I know how he's going to do it. I know how it's going to turn out to be. Tell your neighbor you don't know. And you see, God does not waste time explaining the process. Someone said God does not waste time explaining the process. Exodus 3:8, the children of Israel, I'm going to take you to a land flowing with milk and honey. I didn't hear God say, but it has to be through the wilderness. And I came down to deliver them out of the hand of what? The Egyptians. And to bring them up out of the what? Onto the land, and a large, onto a land flowing with what? Milk and honey. Onto the place of the what? Canaanites, and the Hittites, and the Amorites, and the Perizzites, and the Hivites, and the what? God didn't mention anything about the route. That's why visions are important. Someone said visions are important. I'm going to show you where you're headed. But oftentimes, let me tell you something. We don't know what happens between where we are and where we're headed. We don't even know how God is going to do it. I told you a story sometime here. That one time God told me, I'm going to promote you. I didn't know how it was going to happen. Then I had a dream. God speaks to me through dreams, and they happen occasionally. But most times they do. I saw a bomb blast in our office. I was working there in Apapa. A bomb blast in our office and everybody ran out. And as we ran out, they said, okay, people start coming back. Some of us, come. Ah, why people running? Others had run further. I didn't understand that thing. And there were no bomb blasts in Lagos at that time because it was in the 90s. And what happened was they came in, gave everybody a sack letter in the office. Everybody left. Then they started sending a letter to some of us they wanted to recall and promoted us. Now, if God told me he was going to promote me, I would think that one day I'll be on my table and they'll give me a letter. I didn't know it was going to start with a sack. I was good at my job. When the sack touched, it was a shock. But somehow I had peace in my mind. It didn't take time. 2 weeks later, they just wrote me again. So you've made accounts manager wages. Come back. Some other people that left didn't come back. So the way they did the cleansing was that everybody left. Then the people they wanted to retain, they sent them letters individually and brought them back. But whoever knew. And you see, when God tells you I will promote you, God will not tell you you'll be sacked first. Sack does not look clean to the sight of a man. But God weighs the spirit. The spiritual God deals with unsightable. But men deal with the sightable. That's why funfair breaks out before men, because they think things are going to move through a particular path. God, why would you tell us about the land flowing with milk and honey? But you never mentioned, oh my God. You never mentioned about the wilderness. And if you look at Deuteronomy chapter 8 verse 2, God was the one that led them through that wilderness. Look at Psalm 78 verse 52. God led them. God was their guide. How can you guide us through a place where there is no water? How can you guide us through a place where we'll question whether there will be food for us to eat? How can you guide us through a route where it appears as if there is no abundance? Because many of us think that once it's the promised land, it must be a polished path. So, while they were in the wilderness, God was the one guiding them. So, Pharaoh was chasing them, but God was guiding them. How can you be guiding me and others are chasing me? Because many of us think that once God is guiding you, nothing should chase you. These are the sight of men. All the ways of men are clean in their heart because they reason in a particular way. If this person is doing this and this is moving like that, the person must be successful. You don't know that God has different plans for different people. God may do certain things to channel you to the place of your destiny. And it may start with something that appears negative. I'm telling you as a prophet. It may start with something very negative. I can tell you different examples in scripture. Negativity starts. How do you explain a woman who is about to give birth? Pain must be accompanied birth. If it's a child coming to the world and children are the heritage of the Lord and the fruit of the womb is his reward, why must he come with pain? And God has exalted him and given him a name that's above every other name. And the name of Jesus, every knee shall what? He had a crown, but it didn't start like that. He had a crown of thorns first. Some ways are thorny first before they become rosy. Somebody was saying that Peter P. Before he wears this crown, he will cry. That crying is part of it. He has already cried once on TV, so let that be the only cry. I told God, let this man not cry too much. They will not abandon this quest. A man that's genuinely broken. The devil, devil is real. Though. See, devil. Many of you are under covering. Devil is real. That's why you need to be on fire all the time. Yes, sir. Somebody say fire. Am I glorifying? Satan is an idiot. I can't glorify him, but it's real. I don't fear him. His anger is everywhere. If you're not doing anything, the devil will not be angry with you. Are you following what I'm saying? When your life is sweet, that's when it attracts ants. You say, well, this is following me. You are anointed. Your life is sweet. That's why this is following. That's why they are following you. They will not write anything on your building until you begin to put cladding. As long as you don't plaster and leave it, nobody will remember you. Once you decide to go up, people come and mark X. I'm telling you, this thing may be physical, but I can use it and preach a message to you. No, once it is not cemented, nobody, Satan will not remember you once you begin to do some nice things that will make the beauty come out. Your building is too high. It is blocking other buildings. Did I tell you not to build a high building? My friend told me sometime that his brothers, they built in a particular, bought a big expanse of land in acres. So everybody had their duplex, has many brothers. And he was building his own. If you see his house, like a castle. House that stones were imported from abroad. Stones, these stones they put on the wall, brought in from abroad. I went to that house, I said, oh boy, now you build this thing. He said, yes. We'll give God the praise. He said that immediately he began to build. His brothers went and met his father and his mother and told them, this guy's house is becoming too big, it's blocking our own. Satan can penetrate a family and make sure. I'm telling you how this thing works. It makes sure that once you begin to decide to rise to a particular level, they will show up. And when they come, if you have revelation, you will laugh. Somebody say you will laugh. Why do they hear the rage and the people imagine venting against the Lord and is what? Demented. Once you're anointed, the rage will increase. Amen? Once you are anointed, tell your neighbor, once you're anointed and your anointing is growing, the rage will increase. Don't think that rage comes to those who don't have anything to do. You think you're doing nothing. They don't want you to manifest. Wait until you put searchlight. You know what they call searchlight? In the night, you put one searchlight, maybe the whole of this region in the night. From people say, well, where's that light coming from? You know, this kind of type of light you see in them on mast. Some people say this is blocking their view, they can't sleep at night. We couldn't sleep at night. Isn't it blocking our? If when that light is on, it enters our bedroom. Buy thick curtains or blinds and cover your what? Windows. You can sleep. Nobody, you see, sometimes we think we know how God is going to do what he's going to do. But let me tell you, no matter how much we prophesy, we still know in part. That's why God gives everybody a little bit of the story. You will see interim government here. Eh? You will see presidency here. You will see winner here. You will see this one there. Except you paint a composite picture, you won't understand what God is saying. And you know one thing, everybody is saying, I'm the right one. God didn't tell you anything, I'm the right one. No, you have to paint the whole picture to know the direction of where God is headed. Because things will happen though. You don't believe me? No, the way when they shake head, and I said, I don't even tire. Anything where you go, be making me. Praise the Lord. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout a loud covenant hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So God was the one that was guiding his people while they were disturbing Moses that there is no water to drink. God was the one guiding people when they said they were tired of what? Manna, and he sent what? Quails. He was the one that was guiding the people when Pharaoh chased them and the Red Sea had to open and they walked through it. God, if you could have explained this process to us, we will never be agitated. But all you told us in Egypt was that I'm taking you to a land flowing with milk and honey. You didn't tell me that if I'm going to go to this land, look at the things that are going to happen. Meanwhile, you're the one. How can you give us this word and yet we are going through what we are going through? And you still say you are the one guiding us. Every good and perfect gift is from what? Above. But you see, knowing the mind of God in a particular season is of great benefit. Because you can know the whole Bible, but don't know the mind of God for a particular season. And that's what happened to many Christians. They know scriptures, but they can't understand what God is saying now. Because if we understand what God is saying now, our anxiety will be lifted. We will not be troubled like people who don't understand. We will not be following things sheepishly. It just be aside, watching events, praying and watching, knowing the direction you ought to pray. A lot of people have already given up. A lot of people have already given up. I just read some statements and giving up. I thought about you've given up. So that's your level. That is, God can remove all the judges. Take them home if need be. In fact, do you know how to Google the names of Supreme Court judges? Yeah. I listened to the names. I said, God, the heart of kings. You call the name one by one. That's how to pray. I Googled their name. I saw their names. I began to put in terms these people agree. Who is likely to agree? But the problem is that what is happening now is not one person that is fighting. It's not one person that is fighting. It's going to be difficult. It's going to be bad. This is not a good taste of victory. It's victory that comes with many buts. No, you wish I didn't. Because usually what made this man's own in 2015 to be smooth was that this man went and what? Conceded what? People have refused to concede. And for the first time, most times I only see one person going to God. This time there are multiple people who have states. So it is good. Amber. As I said, go out and vote. It's not over yet. The devil wants you to be downcast, deflated, decide that this country is finished. All I need to know is how to what? Get out of here. I did this, get out of here. Praise God. Don't ever put your vision in a way that you cannot be able to. Because let me tell you one thing about vision. Let me be sick. You know, many of us write vision. My vision statement is this: every day we'll keep amending vision. Because no matter how much God tells you, you cannot get a full accept. As time goes on, things begin to expand. As time goes on, certain things will be cut off. You now begin to say, I thought this was my vision. You see people begin to reshape their vision. It's good to have strategic visions. But let me tell you, many times, Genesis 12:1, leave your father and your mother to the land I will what? Show you. If they ask you your vision at that time, what will you say? To the land he will show me. Is that not what you would say? No, but that's what God told him now. Why do you want to leave? Because he's taking me to the land he will. Somebody will tell you, God does not operate like what? Because men think God has to operate in a particular way. That's why, as time goes on, all the visions we wrote for Ministry Rose started. God has broadened our horizon. Certain things we put in there are being cut off. You are getting a full expression of what God is calling you to. You have grown in understanding. You are taking steps that are huge that you never imagined you could take before. And now, this thing is being interpreted differently. But before you know it, it begins to change how your vision is structured. Because as time goes on, the tunnel vision begins to what? Increase. You know, when you're moving through a tunnel, initially what you see at the beginning is not what you see when you enter. It begins to increase. You begin to see all kinds of things. You begin to see all kinds of things. You begin to see detours. You begin to see, oh my God. To the land I will show you. How do I explain this? Because God may never explain the process. The expectation of the righteous will not be cut off. But the route to manifestation can be cut off. We can move on land today. Tomorrow we'll begin to move in the sea. Let me tell you, when God gives you a land, sometimes God will not tell you all the contentions. You will fight on money level. God, maybe will come and mark X. You will do all kinds of things. You will run here. Traditional rulers will come. People will come and lay claim. God will not tell you that. Maybe what God will tell you is that I've given you the land to what? Possess it. That possessing is a big word filled with all manner of potpourri. If you are not careful, many have abandoned God-given projects because they feel that God was not in it. Let me tell you, do you know that wilderness was a test for Israelites? In the test they give you in school, does a invigilator come and begin to explain the test to you? Test is not explained. Likewise, your test is the route to your next level. Many times, that route is not explained. Don't wait for God to explain it for you. He will never explain it. You may be going through it, but God is the one guiding you. Don't let anybody make you feel that you are out of God's will because of what you are facing. Let no one tell you you are out of God's will because of what you are facing. You are in God's will. He's guiding you. Someone say, if it's God, why? You see, I've gone past preaching that kind of message. Every good and perfect gift is from what? Even babies are perfect gifts. But you must push. You will cry. Sometimes you will have nausea. Is it not so? You will vomit. You will spit. Sometimes you will lack appetite. But it's a good and perfect gift. Sometimes, let me tell you something. It may be good and perfect. The outcome is good and perfect, but the process may not be perfect. The right path may not always look as the right way. This man had won election now. After he made a press conference in a Nikon in Abuja, as he was coming out, people were hailing him from the balconies. You would just know that this one is loved by people. And clearly, God is in it. Yes, sir. But God never told him, at the end of the day, you will cry. You will go to court. So this is what you see contesting under LP that won election. They will change party. What I'm seeing now, they will leave that party and go to other parties. Some people, because they will start winning them now. So that man will be like a lone ranger. If you don't hold on to what God has told you, you will miss it. Because many of us, what is keeping us in this work we're doing is what God has told us. Not even the way human beings are behaving. It's the thing that God told us. That's what is holding us. So when you remember, you go back to what? The word, the scripture of God, and begin to look at it. You read Isaiah 49 again. Isaiah 62 verse 10. You begin to read and say, ah, God, listen, God will tell you, yes. I will not explain the process. No matter how much you try, all I've told you, I'm going to make you a millionaire. I'm going to make you own a university. Do you know this landscape school we had? Was it not one time I told you I had a revelation? And God spoke to me and gave me a name, Landscape University. I asked God the other day, We are still battling with. Is it primary school, maybe to secondary? Which time will the university come now? But the university will come. Landscape University. That landscape school, that name, you know, we're battling about now. I told you landscape. Because let us start with secondary school. Let's start with primary school. Pre-nursery, nursery, primary, secondary, then it goes to what? The vision is there. When I had that dream, I thought it was going to be in 10 years' time. You know, when I tell you that in the next 10 years of your life will be perfect, you think that everything will be easy. Somebody give me that prophecy now. In that church. Man of God, the next 10 years of your life, things will be easy. You know what I was thinking out there? That means warfare has gone. But I've fought some of the greatest battles I've fought in that 10 years. I'm not saying things have been letting. You know, the thing is that the things I could have been celebrating before that happened to me, when they happen now, they are normal. Pretty normal to me. There are many good things that happened to me, but they are not. I'm no longer as excited. The outlook I had about ministry before, you know, pastoring, if God decided that this is what I let it be. Amen? No, I'm not going to. The Bible said that though Israel be not gathered, yet will you be glorious in the sight of God. So there are things that may not add up, but God will still be God and God will still beautify your life. Do your own part. Somebody says, if God takes all the glory, he should also be able to bear the shame. Are you following what I'm saying? If God takes out, he should also be able to what? Take all the shame. Because he don't tamper with his glory. So he's taking all the glory. So when that shame comes, you tell God, I never touched the glory. So where's this shame coming from? Because your name is at stake. I will lead you through the paths of what? Righteousness for my name. Somebody say for his name's sake. There are certain things that God is doing in your life for his name's sake. Not because of you. For his name's sake. So you will not fail for his name's sake. You will not be impoverished for his name's sake. There are things that will happen in your life because God's name is at stake. Praise the Lord. Why would God speak about Jesus and say that his place is on my right hand in heavenly what? Places. But something caught my fancy. Ephesians chapter 4 verse 9. God said that he that what? Ascended. First what? Now let me ask you a question. You know you can be here and begin to go up. That means ascending. But do you know what the Bible says? I never saw it like this. Bible says, he that ascended, first what? Descended. So instead of going up, God has spoken that you will ascend. Instead of going up, you started what? Descending. And the Bible is not saying, not even descending. You descended to the lower parts. How can you tell me I'm going to ascend? Meanwhile, everything I'm seeing around me is that I'm descending. I preached this kind of message before. The way up is down. You take roots downwards and barefoot upwards. I preached this message before. But the truth is that, how does God move and determine this kind of movement? Why do I need to? He that ascended, this statement is a very powerful statement. First, someone say first. He descended first. He that was crowned was, first of all, a crown of what? Thorns. Many of us understand that is a first. That first comes before you begin to step into the rest of what God has promised you. And many times people don't appreciate the first. How can this thing happen? How can this happen? If you are truly of God, a lot of people are justifying what happened the other day and say, you know, I told people, I say, pastors are not the one that win elections. So people should not go for spiritual endorsement. That you have to do this one, you have to do, of course, there should be alliances. You have to do this one, you have to do that one, you have to do that one, you have to do, because everybody cannot wait, understand that there's a way God functions. God's ways are not our ways. God works in a mysterious way. You may not understand him, but he tells you, look at the picture ahead. If you are not a person, so I say, you don't use a tape to measure God, use faith. Can get tape and begin to measure God. Begin to explain. What I think now is that God is just trying to, God has a way of doing things. And, you know, I think God just wants to show us. God doesn't want us to show you what? God wants to show us that he's God. That's true. God just wants to tell us that this and that. There are things you can't explain. Many of you cannot explain what is going on in your life now. Am I talking to you? Many of you cannot explain. Meanwhile, you heard God clearly. You heard God marry this person. Marry this person. This person is your what? But Father, I can't understand. What is going on? Why are things working out like this? All things work together for the good of them that love God. For the good of them who are the called according to his will and purpose. I announce to you today, it is not over yet. God has spoken. All we need to do is hold on to what he has said. He may not explain the process, but God is clearly on the throne. Don't use permutations to understand God. Use revelations to understand him. Let's rise up.
Church.
Let the church
say.